The drive for me now is to control boxing, to control the sport globally and have a single entity running boxing like the UFC. If you want to bet against me, you will see. I am the man for the job. I'm the only one that can do it. Eddie Hearn. An indignant Lennox Lewis, CBE, CM, states the following. Social media is great for connecting and sharing ideas. Thumbs up. But do me a favor. If you want to talk boxing with me, at least do some real boxing homework. Start from the golden era of heavies. That's 50 years of boxing information from then to now. Know your boxing history, not opinions. Hashtag rant. Four Kings Files. Leonard vs. Hearns. It was a classic confrontation. The skilled boxer in Sugar Ray versus the awesome power puncher in Hitman Hearns. It was a fight the world couldn't wait to see. Hearns vs. Leonard. World Welterweight Championship. Caesars Palace, September 16, 1981. According to Michael Benson, Eddie Hearn has revealed he had talks with Golden Boy President Eric Gomez yesterday about Canelo Alvarez versus Colin Smith. He said they discussed numbers, as Smith has said he's willing to take less money than before. Source IFL. Apparently, it's Canelo Alvarez's birthday today. Guadalajara, Jalisco. Boxing news and history. They state Canelo was born Santos Saul Alvarez Berrigan in Guadalajara, Jalisco, Mexico on this day in 1990. Feliz cumpleaños, champ. Here's your regular reminder that Ken Noto vs. Larry Holmes in 1978 is forever one of the all-time greatest big man battles. 15 action-packed rounds, absolute greatness from both warriors. Never gets old, just saying. Heavyweight history. Adrian Broner. This shit still sharp, and anybody can still get it. Still adjusting to fame, AB. So here's the return of the gentleman who was supposed to be the heir apparent for Felix Trinidad. To Trinidad, but unfortunately couldn't measure up to that great standard. Still, as I can probably presume, and I assume here, still favored very much by the promoter Bob Arum, despite sort of falling off, literally falling off a bike, nearly thrown his derail in his career completely, but returning, as we can see here, being given another opportunity on Top Rank, because as I said, I think he happens to be one of the favorites. There could be a variety of reasons, because he happens to have the look. He comes from Puerto Rico. He's a inroad into the Puerto Rican market as a fighter, and I think Bob Arum is trying to sell him as such, and will keep on selling him as such. There have been for years many who have doubted his talent and ability in any case, and I've never really paid that much attention to him. Nevertheless, he states here, it will be something different to fight in the bubble. Thursday, we will win and this diamond will shine. Felix Verdejo on his main event opportunity. Verdejo is back. Wow. Gran trabajo, brother. Gran trabajo. Great victory, I believe that means, right? Oh, great win. Let's see what he did. Okay, Gran Trabajo indeed, but who did he Trabajo against? It is what it is. Congratulations, Yalafau. Apparently, Teofimo Lopez was on WBC Talks round 82 yesterday, Friday the 17th. I haven't seen any sound bites from it and I didn't watch it, so I'm guessing that whatever he said wasn't of any great consequence. Or maybe there's just a delay and people haven't bothered to pass out any interesting bits yet. Nevertheless, it's a good picture in any case, so I'll put it up.
Systematic. There's a nice left hook and another one, but it's one at a time. You gotta follow with the right, but a left counter on the right by Sugar Ray Robinson. I truly believe it.
Matchroom Boxing, 5 weeks to go. Dillian White versus Povetkin. Katie Taylor versus Persoon. Plus more. Fight Camp, hashtag White Povetkin, hashtag Taylor Persoon 2. Practice, 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 repetition, repetition, repetition. I've been fighting southpaws in my sleep for the last 5 months. Now only weeks to go, can't wait for this. Matchroom Boxing, 7th August, and still. Terry Harper. So I heard about this, and here it is being expressed in Irish Boxing. Eddie Hearn signs Katie Taylor rival. Let's read some of this. Undisputed lightweight champion Katie Taylor has been joined in the Matchroom stable by one of her mandatory challengers. It was announced this afternoon that that undefeated Northampton puncher Chantelle Cameron, 12-7-0, the former EU silver and bronze medalist, is mandatory to Taylor's WBC title, as well as Jessica McCaskill's light welterweight WBC belt, and has been pushing hard for a title shot. Now signing with Matchroom, it would appear to make the Taylor showdown a fight many believe is one of the toughest out there for the Irish woman, more likely. Cameron is officially managed by Cyclone Promotions boss Barry McGuigan, but is undergoing a messy split with the Irishman.